Next is alkynes. The alkynes, the molecule, this is also unsaturated compound, and the general formula is CnH2n-2. So this is the general formula for alkyne. See, here similar way, that's here number n indicates the number of carbon atoms. So suppose suppose n is equal to 2, means this will be C2, and H2 4 minus 2, that will be H2. That's mean C triple bond C on H bond H. So this is the basic compounds of the alkyne. So the common name is acetylene and the IUPAC name is ethyne. Okay. Now this is the first stable member of alkyne series. See, and this acetylene is used for the arc welding purpose in the form of the oxyacetylene flame obtained by mixing acetylene with the oxygen gas. So alkynes are starting materials for a large number of organic compounds. So now we'll see the preparation properties, uses of alkyne. Then before that, we have to see the nomenclatures and the isomers. So nomenclatures of alkynes and isomerisms of the alkynes. First, nomenclature, simply they are end with, that is the suffix. For example, alkane compound, you know that alkane compound, they are end with AC. See, the removal of that removal of that ANE, addition of that for alkyne compound YNE, that is the suffix YNE. For example, ethyne, the molecular formula is C2H2, ethyne. And then propyne. So like this. So the molecular formula propyne, butyne. So then the possible isomers. See, already you have learned that the ethyne and propyne, they have only one structure. Propyne, the formula is what? CH3CCH. And this having, that is the only one structure, CH, that is equal to CH triple bond CH. The ethyne and propyne have only one structure. This is for the isomerism. Suppose if I have the carbon number 5 and hydrogen is 8. So what is the possible arrangements of the structures? There are two possibilities are there. That is, one is, suppose if I have carbon 2, 3, suppose if I have the carbon 4 members of carbon, this means what is the possible structure? Means you have to draw that carbon 4 carbon atom, then first position is possible, one triple bond is possible. Then second position also one triple bond is possible. Suppose if I draw the triple bond here, means again become the same one, so that the C4 carbon number 4 having the two possible arrangements. Similar way, the carbon number 5, then you have to satisfy with the hydrogen atom, that is CH3 CH2 CH. So count number of the hydrogen atom, 5, 6. So C4H6. Similar way here also, that is CH3, then CH3. So this is the possible arrangement for, this is but 1-9, this is but 2-9, this is the number 1 carbon, 2, 3, 4. So that but 1-9, this will be a 1, 2, 3, 4 but 2-9. Okay, so this is the possible arrangement. Then what about the C5H8? Is C5H8 will be, see, look at this compound C5H8. The possible isomeric structure will be, let us draw the number of carbon atoms. So totally 5 carbon atoms are there. So this one possibility, that means the triple bond, suppose the triple bond is present here, means there is the one possibility. So that CH triple bond, then remaining is CH2 CH2 CH3. Is it correct? Yes. So then totally 5 7 8, right? Then next possible arrangement is the second position. Then the second position having one triple bond, 5 carbon atoms. So the second position means here. So the second position having triple bond. So remaining thing is CH3 CH2 CH3. So this is the another possible arrangement. Then the third, they have one branch. The two possibilities are completed. Suppose if I draw here, mean that again become will be a second position. Suppose if I draw here, mean that again, so it will become a first position. So that the another possibility is, I'm going to draw the branch, one branch here. Then the triple bond I'm going to write here. Now remaining thing is hydrogen 6, then here one hydrogen and here one hydrogen. Now satisfied. So this is the three possible arrangements of the that is the three possible, that is the IUPAS in isomers they have some three isomers in this C5H8 compound. So this name will be pent 1-ine, this is because of the first position having the triple bond. So pent 1-ine, then this will be the second position having the triple bond, so that pent 2-ine. Then this having one branch, that is one branch, that's mean one substituent methyl group are there, the word root is 4, so that bute 1. So that first position having triple bond, so that ine, bute 1-ine, the substituent is what, methyl. So that 1 2 3, third position having the methyl group, so 3 methyl, then bute 1-ine, 3-methyl bute 1-ine. So this, look at this, the first two structures are the position isomer, and structure 1 and 3 and 3 are the chain isomers. Okay, then structure of the triple bond we will see. Structure of triple bond. See, ethane is the simplest molecule of alkane series. See, this is the structure of the ethane. Look at this. Here, the each carbon atom of the ethane has two sp hybridized orbital. Okay, the carbon-carbon, that is the single bond, that is the sigma bond, is obtained by the head-on overlapping of the two sp hybridized orbitals of the two carbon atoms. So the remaining sp hybridized orbitals of each carbon atom undergoes the overlapping along the internuclear axis with the 1s orbital of each of the two hydrogen atoms. So this is the 1s orbital. Okay, this is 1s and this is also 1s orbital. Here CH sigma bond is formed, so that the bond angle is 180 degree. Then the p orbitals, which are the perpendicular to each other, the, as well as to the plane of the CC sigma bond. So the 2p orbital, next to this is the 2p orbital of the one carbon atoms are parallel to the other, that is the 2p orbitals of the other carbon atom, this. So which undergoes the lateral, that is the sideways overlapping to the form 2π bonds, that is 2π bonds between the two carbon atoms. So that's the ethane molecule consists of one CC carbon-carbon sigma bond and two that is two pi bond, that is carbon carbon sigma bond, 2 CH sigma bond and 2 CC pi bond, carbon carbon pi bond. So here the bond strength, that is the bond C triple bond C, it is carbon triple bond, carbon triple bond carbon S, the bond enthalpy is 823 kilojoule per mole, is more than that of the carbon double bond, carbon-carbon double bond bond enthalpy, that is 681 kilojoule per mole. Then carbon-carbon single bond is 348 kilojoule per mole. So the carbon-carbon triple bond, the bond length is 133 picometer and the carbon-carbon single bond is 120 picometer. The carbon-carbon double bond is 133 picometer and carbon-carbon single bond is 154 picometer. So here the electron cloud, look at this. The electron cloud between the two carbon atoms, cylindrical, that is symmetrical about the internucleus axis. So the molecule is linear, the molecular structure is linear. Okay, so this is the structure of triple bond. Then preparation, that is preparation of alkyne. First method is from calcium carbide. See, on the industrial scale, the ethyne is prepared by treating with calcium carbide and water. The calcium carbide is prepared by heating quicklime with coke. Then, look at this again. Then quicklime can be obtained by heating limestone also gives. So, then you will get the ethyne molecule. So, you will get the ethyne. So, calcium carbonate on heating, you will get the calcium oxide, then carbon dioxide. The calcium oxide further on treatment with coke, you will get that calcium carbide. Then the calcium carbide treatment with water to form ethyne. Okay, this is the method. The next method is from the vicinal dihalides. Preparation from the vicinal dihalides. See, the vicinal dihalides, this is the vicinal dihalides on treatment with the alcoholic potassium hydroxide undergo the dehydrohalogenation. So, one molecule of hydrogen halide is eliminated to form the alkynyl halide with on treatment with the soda amide gives alkyne. So, this is the reaction. So, here the removal of KBr, then removal of water. So, the remaining things is formed. This is amide compound. Then, removal of the sodium bromide and the ammonia, you will get the ethyne molecule. Then the properties, physical and chemical properties. First, we will see the physical property. The physical properties are alkyne follows the same trends of the alkenes and the alkane. The first three members are gases and next eight are liquids and their higher ones are solid. Now, all alkynes are colorless. Ethyne has the characteristic order. So, other members are orderless. That alkynes are weakly polar in nature and they are lighter than water and immiscible with water but soluble in organic solvent like ether, carbon tetrachloride, benzene, acetone, like this. So the melting point and the boiling point density increase with increase in the molar masses. Next, we'll see the chemical properties. See, chemical properties of alkyne. The alkyne source usually acidic nature, so addition reaction and the polymerization reaction are main chemical properties. See, first we'll see the acidic character of the alkyne. The acidic character of alkyne, the sodium metal and soda amide are strong bases. So this is the sodium metal and the soda amide is a strong basis. This here they react with ethyne to form the sodium acetanilide, that is acetylide, with the liberation of the hydrogen gas. So these reactions have not been observed in the case of the ethene and ethane, thus indicating that ethane is acidic in nature in comparison to the ethene and ethane. Okay, you have read that the hydrogen atom is ethanes are attached to sp hybridized carbon atom, whereas they are attached to the sp2 hybridized carbon atoms in the ethene and sp3 hybridized carbon in ethane. You know that is due to the maximum percentage of the S character. The sp hybridized orbitals of carbon atom in ethyne molecule have the highest electronegativity because the sp 50% each s orbitals and p orbital having 50%, that is the character of the orbital. Then
the attract of sad electron pair of the CH bond in ethene to greater extent than that of the sp2 hybridized orbital carbon in ethene and the sp3 hybridized orbital carbon in the ethane. So thus ethane hydrogen atom can be liberated as proton more easily to compare ethene and ethane. So hence the hydrogen atoms of ethane attached to triply bonded carbon atom are acidic in nature. You may note that the hydrogen atoms attached to the triply bonded carbon are acidic, but not all the hydrogen atoms are alkyne. See, first look at this. The ethane react with the sodium metal to form the sodium monosodium ethanide. That liberation of the hydrogen gas, then they form, they again react with one more sodium metal, this monosodium ethanide, again react with one more sodium metal to form disodium ethanide, then sodamide. The sodamide gives the sodium propanide. Okay, then so this reaction, usually this reaction are not shown by the alkenes and alkanes. Hence, used for the distinction between the alkynes and alkenes and alkanes. What about the above, the reaction with but-1-9 and but-2-ine means what? That is, the alkanes, alkenes and alkynes have the following trends in the acidic behavior. So that ethyne is greater than, ethene is greater than ethane. Okay, this is the acidic behavior. So similar way here, ethane is greater than propyne is greater than butyne. That means but-2-ine. Okay, this is propyne. This is but-2-ine. Then the addition reaction. The addition reactions of alkynes contain a triple bond, so that add up to the two molecules of dihydrogen, halogen, hydrogen halides. You can write like this. So the formation of the hydrogen, formation of the addition product takes place according to the following step. Like the carbon-carbon triple bond react with the HZ to form vinylic cation. Then the vinylic cation to form like this. So the addition product of the depends upon the stability of the vinylic cation. So addition in the unsymmetrical alkynes takes place according to the Markovnikov rule. So the majority of the reaction of alkynes are examples of the electrophilic addition reaction. We can see the electrophilic addition, some examples in addition reaction. Now, addition of hydrogen, dihydrogen. Here, the addition of dihydrogen in ethane molecule in the presence of platinum, palladium or nickel catalyst using that formed ethene, that is alkyne converts to alkyne, then addition of hydrogen you will get alkane. So that is the product is ethane. Then similarly react with propyne or prop-1-ine react with hydrogen, then in the presence of platinum, palladium, nickel catalyst you will get again alkene, that is prop-1-ine. Then addition of hydrogen you will get propane. So this is the addition reaction of the dihydrogen. Then the addition of halogen. The addition of halogen is, suppose if you add bromine, dibromine in propyne to form alkene, that is 1,2 dibromopropene is formed. Again further adding of bromine, that you will get 1,1,2,2 tetrabromopropane is obtained. So this is the addition of halogen. Then addition of hydrogen halide. When react with hydrogen bromide, ethane react with the hydrogen bromide. So what happens mean HCl or HBr, whatever it is, see HI, anything you can use here, HBr is used. Have to alkyne to form gem dihalide, that is geminal dihalides. See, look at this reaction, formation of bromoethene, then 1,1 dibromoethane is obtained. So this is the addition reaction of hydrogen halide. Then the next reaction is this is the 1,1 dibromo, sorry, this is the no this is the this is one 1,1 I wrote the structure in a different type. That is why just confusing. See here, this is the 1, 1 dibromo ethane, and react with propyne, the hydrogen bromide, to form two bromo propene, and again react with the bromine to find what happens mean to obtain 1, 2, 2 dibromo propane. So this is addition of hydrogen halide. Then addition of water. The addition of water like alkanes and alkynes are also immiscible and do not react with water. However, one molecule of water adds to alkyne on warming with mercuric sulfate. So Hg mercuric 2, that is mean sulfate, and dilute sulfuric acid at 333 Kelvin temperature to form the carbonyl compounds. So this undergoes isomerism process so that they forms a carbonyl compound. Here the carbonyl compound is aldehyde and this is a ketone. So the both having the carbonyl group. Next is a polymerization. See, the polymerization, linear polymerization and the cyclic polymerizations are there. The first, the linear polymerization. See, under the suitable condition, the linear polymerization of ethyne takes place to produce polyacetylene or the polyethyne, which is a high molecular weight. The polyethylene containing the repeating unit of, that is, this polyene containing the repeating unit of like this. So, it can be represented like this. So, just put a N. This means N number of molecules. So, under a special condition, the polymers conduct electricity also. Then, that is the thin film of the polyacetylene can be used as the electrodes in batteries. These films are good conductors, lighter and cheaper than the metal conductors. Okay. Then, next is the cyclic polymerization. The cyclic polymerization, ethyne on passing through red hot iron tube, that is at 873 Kelvin, undergoes a cyclic polymerization. So, three molecules are polymerized to form benzene. See, this one and this one and this one. Three molecules of ethyne. So, which is the starting molecule for the preparation of derivatives of benzene, dyes, drugs and large number of the other organic compounds. So, this is the best route for entering from aliphatic to aromatic compound. Okay. So, the formation of benzene like this. Next class, we will discuss the aromatic hydrocarbons.